One announcement before we get started. Next week is going to be a genre theme night. As you guys have seen, it's going to be show tunes, Broadway. So be ready. I know Rachel's excited. I know she's not here right now, but I'm sure others as well. And myself and Dan and Chris, we've been collecting these polls for quite some time, and we keep seeing the ones that are kind of rising to the top. So probably what we're going to do is, have this month's theme night be show tunes, Broadway. Then we'll get a poll for the artist theme night for next month. And then probably what we'll do for the following theme night for the genre is do female artists, because that came up in second place. And if you guys see that it's tied, it was virtually, but Cindy's vote put it over the edge.
Yep, Cindy decided.
That's right. No, so it's great. So we'll
Voting counts, people. Voting
we'll
counts.
have that. We will have another poll though coming up
Rock the vote.
probably next week after we get done with the genre night, so we can get your votes for the artist theme night. So we'll keep that going. It seems like everybody likes to participate in that, and it's fun. I love hearing everybody's versions of and contributions and participation of the selected genre or artist theme. So
Should be fun. Should be really fun.
without further ado, I'll get started. So I'm gonna start, and then up on deck we've got Rob Castrogiovanni. Hi, Rob. And then in the hole we've got Rachel. So I'm gonna perform a song, and I will mute you guys. Looks like everybody's muted already. Thanks, Dan. I'm gonna bring up some lyrics since I haven't been playing much. I'm going to do the merry-go-round song. Oh, look at that. There we go. I'm actually gonna need to cheat and read them probably. All right, this song is called Merry-Go-Round by yours truly, Chad Root. Here we go.
She's looking up, she's looking down, and down. We found her.
Nice.
Very much. Memphis Hawk has joined us. What's up, Steve?
Good evening. How's it going?
Going well.
Memphis Hawk in the house.
Good to see you. I'm liking seeing your face more often. Sorry I wasn't here to greet you last week, but glad
to miss you last week, but
yeah, Steve, cool. You've played some great songs last week.
Heck yeah. Looks like Dan's got you on the list. He's got you as number 13.
Lucky 13.
That's right. So now we've got a spot filled for 13. Awesome. Well, thank you guys.
So Chris, Jay and Steve are both number 13.
Yeah, that's right. Well, Jay's actually already got a spot at number 4. That was my
Yeah, mistake. I'm glad you didn't forget me.
No, not at all, man. How could I? Our Canadian friend from London, Ontario. How are you, Rob? You're actually up now if you want to.
Not bad. Yourself?
Good, man. Good. Good to see you.
Yeah, you too. Well, I mean, I'd say the same, but I can't see you, so.
That's right. Good being here with you.
Good
online,
to see you.
In this room. On Zoom, right?
Hey, Chad.
Yes.
Your mic is, it's low.
Yeah, it is low. It's pretty low.
Good to know.
I actually recorded our friend Tom Alter this weekend, and I was messing with my mic, so I'm glad you said that. I put it low, thinking that it was going to be way too high because I had it up, so good.
And yeah. How did you record it?
Yeah, no, I did record. I recorded 8 songs of his set that he was playing with, her name is Katie. And
Katie Williamson of After Blue.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they are phenomenal. Katie is amazing, amazing singer, and Tom is obviously an extraordinary guitar player. They were fantastic. Oh my god.
No, me, but you can record other artists.
Yeah. So what I do is, well, I went with a video camera though. I went out and I basically I bought this video camera, this camera. And I've been doing some different things for myself professionally, but also just to get some practice, go out there. I went out there a few weekends ago, probably about a month ago now, with Chris Borowski to the Proving Grounds in Royal Oak, Michigan.
Oh, and you guys are going out?
Yeah, yeah.
We're still on lockdown, so.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, there is still, social distancing and masking precautions. You know, I had to wear a mask the entire time that I was in there. I went out and then I did some experimental stuff just as practice. I'm like, hey, Tom, you know, I'm just going to video record you tonight. I put it together for him real quickly. And he's like, oh, this is great. You know, I want to pay you to do it. I'm like, heck yeah, let's go. So, yeah, it's a good opportunity for me to, share some music and get creative and do some video editing.
So are you on YouTube now?
Soon. It's coming, yes.
Well, let me know. Shit, send me some links of you.
Yeah, no, we'll do, Rob. Absolutely.
All right. So,
all that aside, what do you got to play with us or play for us?
Well, before I do, because I know there's probably some people in the that weren't here a few weeks ago, I'd like to plug my open mic if that's cool.
Absolutely, man. The stage is yours for a good 5 minutes, so go for it, man. Do as you will.
All right. Well, I do. I have this open mic on Friday. It's called Unity and Melody, open mic with me, Rob C. Most of the people that are in here are members, mm-hmm. So they can send you a link if you're interested, or they can post it on the, I was wondering, I know I had to leave for reasons, but if you could, Chad,
sure.
Add me back to the Together Apart message.
Oh yeah, I can do that right now.
Oh, thanks, because I didn't want to leave. I just, you know, because there was someone that, made people leave, and I just left because of
hey,
her.
Man, that's fine. We don't judge people leaving the group and whatnot. I think
that's good, because some people don't like to come back to groups. I mean, some people don't. Once I remove myself from a group, I usually don't like to come back, but.
Yeah, no, that's fine. I mean,
I kind of miss it, you know?
In this digital age, Rob, like. No, nobody really should be offending from going in and out of groups. It's almost kind of like driving your car down the street. It's like you see them, they go past you, you'll probably see them again. You know what I mean? Like,
definitely.
Like, oh my gosh, you know, they scorn me and they're not my friend anymore. I don't think that it really comes off that way. Anymore.
Oh, I didn't have anything against. I didn't do it for because of you or Dan. You guys are doing a great thing there.
Mm-hmm. Oh, thanks, man. Now you're back on the list, and we'll plug your open mic night.
Okay, well, I do an open mic. Last week it was supposed to be because my sister's birthday, so mm-hmm. I wanted to do a Kenny Loggins theme night, but
that's very cool.
I unfortunately have 2 people I went to the school with that joined me, and all they want to do is that one girl wants to do is talk about the old days all the time. I will deal with her because this can't happen at the, my open mic. Yeah. And I will deal with her on Friday if she does, if she does it again. But I'm going to do this Kenny Loggins thing over and over again. Yeah. My sister was kind of pissed off that her birthday got ruined. But
Hey, man, no, it's all good. So I'll send it in the chat. Just a reminder to everybody, and this is actually a reminder for yours truly. Please do not do a group text during Rob's performance because it will be spoken and it will interrupt his performance.
Yeah, I'm blind and my computer talks.
Don't do that. I need the reminder mostly. Go ahead, Rob.
Yeah, I noticed that. It's funny because you do it. But anyway, yeah, I'm going to do a Bare Naked Ladies tune again.
All right, cool, man. Go ahead.
I knew you before the fall of Rome, and I begged you to let me take you home. You were wrong, I was right. You said goodbye, I said goodnight. It's all been done, it's all been done. It's all been done before. I knew you before the West was won, and I heard you say the past was much more fun. You go your way, I'll go mine, but I'll see you next time. It's all been done. It's all been done. It's all been done before. If I put my fingers here, and if I say I love you, dear, and if I play the same three chords, will you just yawn and say, it's all been done, it's all been done, it's all been done before. And bored on a 30th century night, will I see you on the Price is Right? Will I smile, cry, will I smile as we run in down the aisle? It's all been done, it's all been done. It's all been done. It's all been done. It's all been done. It's all been done before. Guys, for having me out again. I said, you know, if I'm feeling good, I mean, I'm a little sore because I got my vaccine yesterday, but I'm feeling great, so thought I'd, you know.
Yeah, well, good, man. Is that your first shot of two? What would you
get? It is. My second one's scheduled for August 30th, but my worker said that might change.
August 30th? That seems like a long time away. I would think.
I know. Unfortunately, the shots, at least here, are 4 months apart.
Really? I'm really surprised with that. I think it's like supposed to be 4 weeks. You know,
it's supposed to be, but they moved it. I'm hoping that, I mean, I'll take what I can get, but I'm really hoping that you might get the
sure. Oh, good, man. Well, hey,
that doesn't sound right.
Yeah, no, it doesn't. Maybe you should ask for the Johnson & Johnson one, because I know Rachel had got it. I know there was like a bit of a scare, but they're really, I mean, with the stats coming out, it was just like, it was a scare. You know what I mean? There wasn't really that many people suffering from the blood clots and whatnot from what I've read.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Well, I got the Pfizer yesterday. So.
Pfizer? Yeah. Gotcha. Yeah, you might want to see if you can get that updated a little bit sooner, because yeah, the sooner the better, man. I mean, August seems like really long. Like,
yeah, especially almost September.
Yeah, exactly.
The interval for Pfizer vaccine is 3 weeks.
3 weeks. Okay, good to know, man. Yeah,
not perfect. 4 months. In fact, if you have to wait 4 months, that's not good for your immunization.
Yeah, that makes sense, because you want that to all, yeah, go through your body. I mean, yeah, Rich, you can talk more technically about it than I.
Well, yeah, because I trust Rich, because Rich is a doctor, so.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, if he says, and I'm going to try and get that straightened out then, if that's the case.
I would, man. That's definitely a little peculiar. Yeah.
See, I don't like it used to be 3 weeks, but then they moved it.
Yeah, definitely try to emphasize that, and yeah, that's what everybody else is doing, and that's what's going to cause, you know, the herd immunity, more, you know, immunization of more people, and that just gets us through this quicker, you know, we don't want to wait.
I got it at the Western Fair, so I'm going to see if I can get it.
Yeah. Cool, man. Well, thanks so much for sharing the song, man. I haven't heard that one in a while by Bare Naked Ladies.
I remember I got that CD for my 18th birthday. That's how old it is.
Yeah, cool.
Yeah, that's a great song.
Rachel, yeah. You're going to be up next, and Jay Sebastian, you're up on deck. Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Chad. How are you?
Doing well. Everything looks so bright back there today. You got like the spring fling going on there.
I do.
I'm
feeling the spring. I'm feeling the spring, and I'm feeling the cabaret tonight.
Yeah, are you? I like
it. I'm going to take us to the cabaret.
Let's go.
How about that?
Let's go.
Clubs are opening up.
Yes.
Had a friend talk to me today. It's like, all right, I got a room on the 28th of June. Do you want to use it if, you know, I can't? I was like, yeah, I love a show. You book the space first and then you decide what the show is. That's right.
Put yourself, make it a deadline. So you have to put pressure to do something.
Exactly. So that happened. So it got me in the cabaret mood. So here we go. We're going to sing about a May, December romance. This is not a day like any other day. This is something special and apart. Something to remember when the coldness of December chills my heart. Something very strange is happening to me. Every face I see seems to be smiling. All the sounds I hear, the bus is changing gear, suddenly appear to be beguiling. Nobody is melancholy, nobody is sad. Not a single shadow on the sea. Some magician's spell has made this magic start. I feel I want to hold each shining moment in my heart. Something strange and gay on this enchanted day seems to be happening to me. Something very strange is happening to me. Every cat I see seems to be purring. I can clearly tell in every clanging bell some forgotten melody reoccurring. Tinker, tinker. soldier, sailor, beggar, man, or thief. Every single leaf on every tree seems to be aware of something in the air. And if only I were younger, I'd put ribbons in my hair. Something's strange and gay on this romantic day seems to be happening. I always like that when the club, when the ice crashes during this songs. I miss that. I should get a track to do that. Like, and the loud waitress on two drink minimum. Don't you love that?
That's right. Awesome job though, Rachel. Very cool.
Thank you.
Yeah, it that is pretty cool to have that background music. Not to bring
that
this
was again. Sublime.
It was.
What sublime. Show? What show?
It's,
what show?
It's Noel, that? It's Noel Coward. And it's Sail Away. Elaine Stritch does a great version of that song, actually. I mean, in her Elaine Stritch way, you know?
Yeah.
I'm with you. It's a legend.
That's right. Very nice job. Always a delight to hear you sing, Rachel.
Thank you, Chad. It's nice to have you back. I missed you last week.
No, I missed you too. I missed all of you. I know.
Okay. Oh,
good to be here.
Hey, Chad.
So we've got Jay Sebastian up next, and then we've got the one and the only right. Snyder Barker on deck. So Jay, you want to take it away?
I do.
Cool,
can you
man.
Hear this? Can you hear me?
I can hear you vocally. Yeah, you want to give us a
can
little.
Can you hear this?
Yeah, I'll say that is a little low though, as in your drum pad.
Yeah.
Let me silence some folks. So, ah, shoot. Okay, there we go.
You hear that?
Yeah, whatever you just did there was good.
That was good? Okay.
Yeah, that's definitely like loud and clear. Now your snare or your hi-hat, whatever you're hitting there with your drum pad.
That's well, that's the way it goes. I just put this together about 2 hours ago. So
okay.
The levels may change at a later date.
That's fine. Go ahead and take it away. I'm sure it'll be fine. You're pretty impressive with your equipment and your performance, so go for
people,
it.
People ask me who my favorite singers are, and I would normally say Joni Mitchell and Bjork, and for men, I would say Leonard Cohen. So this is a Leonard Cohen song, a waltz. To make you jealous of me, but the room just filled up with mosquitoes. They heard that my body was free. Then I took the dust of a long sleepless night and I put it in your little shoe. Yes, I confess that I tortured the dress that you wore for the world to look through. I showed my heart to the doctor, and he said I just have to quit. Then he wrote himself a prescription, and your name was mentioned in it. Then he locked himself in a library shelf with the details of our honeymoon. I hear from the nurse that he's gotten much worse, and his practice is all in a ruin. Well, I heard of a saint who had loved
studied all night in his school. He taught that the duty of lovers was to tarnish the golden rule. And when I was sure that his teachings were pure, he drowned himself in a pool. His body is gone, but back here on the lawn, his spirit continues to drool. Eskimo showed me a movie he'd recently taken of you. The poor man could hardly stop shivering. His lips and his fingers were blue. Well, I suppose that he froze when the wind took your clothes. And I guess he just never got warm. But you stand there so nice in your blizzard of ice. Oh, please let me come into your storm.
That was all kinds of awesome.
That was great, Jay.
Thank you.
That was great.
How do you do that with the instruments and all that? And the
he's got quite the setup, Rob. He's got, you know, the what do you call it? Like the drum pad? Like what do you call that? What's the?
It's a 25-year-old Roland drum pad.
Yeah. Rob. Still, hey, it's working great, man.
And what? And you got all the bells and whistles, like the bell and the guitar.
Yeah. You know, there's like, you know, 125 different drum sounds in there, and you can put your own ones in there. You just record them and put them in here. And
yeah.
And what about the other instruments?
And then those are, you know, things that I play on the keyboard and convert them into MIDI files, basically.
Okay, so you play every instrument.
Yeah. But I got the chords from somewhere. You know,
Sure.
I don't I don't play very good guitar, I'll tell you that right now.
That's okay.
It's okay, neither do I.
That's all right.
Hey, I really like to ask where you got that, like that movie Silkscreen, and what is it, like CinemaScope or something like that? Where is that from? Where do you get that?
I lived in Japan in the mid-90s.
Did you?
These are movie posters that I found at a flea market.
I love that one behind you. Yeah, I love that one behind
so
you.
Cool.
This is Jack Palance here.
Yeah.
And Shelley
Jack
Winters.
You mean
Shelley
Jack Palance?
Jack Palance and Shelley Winters on his leg.
That's so cool. Yeah, she's in a pretty promiscuous position there.
Somewhat, yeah. And he's holding a gun.
Too. I know, I see that. I know. He's got a power stature there.
It's kind of disturbing.
Sun Ra, John Fahey, and Joni Mitchell.
Oh, nice.
Nice.
Yeah, it was really
your
cool.
Your favorites, Joni Mitchell.
I was trying to look up the image or whatever because I saw CinemaScope, but I couldn't find it. So I was curious. So that's really cool, man.
The movie is called I Died a Thousand Times.
Oh, what a cool fucking movie title. That is awesome, man. Thanks for sharing, man. And thanks for your performance, man. It's always a pleasure. I love you at the end. I mean, you're just, you know, you're in it. You know, you're in it to the end, and, you know, you backed up, and you're, you know, doing the yells and the howls. And it's awesome. It sounds great.
Thank you.
Yeah, Jay.
Nice job, Jay. Mike Barker, you're up next. And then, Rich, you're on deck. How's it going, Mike?
Hey, life's going pretty good. How about yourself, man?
Life is going good as well, man. Smooth sailing for now.
All right.
Smooth sailing. Well,
I just wrote this song a couple days ago, and I don't know where it came from. It just, the words just kind of came to me.
You birthed it.
Yeah. And it's sloppy. I'll play it in a mediocre way and wait for another, you know, a good guitarist to, you know, record a great version of it. But here it goes. I call it the Jackalope.
All right.
How's the mix?
We're going to have to work with your guitar. So that sounds pretty distorted as well.
Way loud, way loud.
Yeah. Way too much gain.
Too much gain?
Yeah. It sounds like you're playing an electric guitar, basically.
It does.
And maybe if that doesn't work, Mike, you're
turn it like way down.
Yeah.
Way down.
And whatever you're doing tonight, take a picture of what settings you have and keep them for next week.
Yeah, I don't know why that got turned up.
I feel like we're always messing with your stuff.
Is that any better?
Go ahead and strum it. Yes, better. A little hissy, but definitely not distorted. You might actually even want to bring it up, but give it a few strums. Like, how are you going to play it? If you're going to finger pick it, I'd bring it up. But if you're going to be strumming it pretty hard,
I don't know how to finger pick.
Okay. You were doing a little bit last 2 weeks ago, I mean.
Okay. I hope this sounds good.
Go ahead.
The Jackalope, take two. I was waiting at the saloon.
Mike, I'm going to stop you real quick. So can you bring up your guitar just a little bit? I'm sorry, man. It is really, really soft now.
Okay. The Jackalope. Take three. I was waiting at the saloon, looking for a peace of mind. And in walks a jackalope, sorry as he can be. Said, "Hey there, Mr. Jackalope, bet you got a story to tell." He looked me in the eye, and this is what he said. I've been running and hiding just to save my hide. Judgment day is coming, and it ain't far behind. Truth to tell, I ain't scared at all, but I sure wish you'd take my place. By the look in your eye, I can tell you don't believe your end is coming soon. Well, I said, "Hey, wait a minute there, Mr. Jackalope. That's quite a story you tell. Well, this here ain't no kind of place you can sell sad tales. Now get on down the road some and hightail it out of here." The Jackalope, he looked at me with a teardrop in his eye, and he said, "Mister, I don't think you understand. We can't outrun our fate. If it was up to me, we'd sit down for a drink and tell tall tales all afternoon. But judgment day is coming, you hear it on the wind, like a swarm of locusts from out east. Now, mister, that's all kinds of crazy, this tale that you weave this day. And if I listen to you, I just might believe in the coming of judgment day. But I ain't ready to cash in my chips. This here ain't my final reward. Mr. Jackalope, I would like to believe you, but I'm thinking you ain't real. I tell you I'm as real as this here town. No one can deny my aim. But if it's all the same to you, my friend, you better get your mind into the game. You see, judgment comes in all kinds of forms, and you didn't pass the test. So the end is nigh, and you can kiss goodbye to this here honky tonk. So the moral of the story, do you see a jackalope at the bar? At the bar right next to you, you better listen up. The tale he tells are all true, and you'd be sorry to ignore the fact. Judgment is right around the corner and might smack you in the head. The jackalope has your number, and he might be back for you. So you better heed his tale, or he'll make a chomp out of you. The jackalope.
The jackalope.
That was cool.
Yeah. I love that one.
That was great.
I have no idea where it came from. It just came to me, I think, Sunday night or something like that.
The jackalope came to you in your dreams.
Good.
I think so. Thank you.
Very cool. I mean, honestly, if I saw a jackalope and it started running, you know, towards me with its little antlers and whatnot, I think I'd run. I don't think I'd be running.
I think you should just sit still and wait for the drugs to wear off.
Yes, this is actually a good piece of advice. I like that.
Oh, jeez.
Absolutely. Well, thank you.
Mike, I love that style. I love the style of the talk singing.
Yeah, great. No, it was actually a really, really good performance by you, Mike.
Thank you.
Yeah, well.
That's a keeper. That's a keeper, man.
I can understand a lot of the words and whatnot. So, yeah, it was great. Good story.
Understanding the words is essential, I hear.
It is, man. Hey, man, sometimes I don't say words. True. So I'm the one that confuses a lot of people. But really great job, man. It was a great song.
Thank you.
Rich, you're up next, and Dan, you're going to be on deck.
All right.
Are you still in California, California?
Nope, I'm in Chicago tonight.
Are you? Well, welcome back.
At work. This was written on a train ride from Liverpool Station, London, out to Cambridge. Seem as fickle as the weather, and any time you think you stumbled on a truth, usually it proves to be just medical opinion. She left me today. What settles in my chest is just an urge to get away. Overheard from headphones across the aisle on my train. A young English romantic sings of politics and rain, and it's pouring outside. Couldn't ask for better weather. I want to run and hide, but all I can do is remember when she lay by my side. We fought like cats and dogs. It hasn't rained like this in some time. I pick up a phone and I put it to my head. Maybe I'll hear the sea. A bit one-sided conversation, the ringing, the waves. It's not any to ring her up, cause I know just what she'd say. That is if she was even home. Set up again, mate. Could I need at least one more pint tonight? Nearly overcome by thirst. And by this strange desire to leave through any portal feet first. sitting outside. Thanks, man, I just sit here at the curb. I'm better getting soaked and getting pissed, but I can learn and she lay by my side. Man, I just lied like a dog. She said dogs don't lie. Come on, have some self-respect, Rich. The skin shows that my pants leg a bit more than I expected. Now my heart has turned out a bureaucrat, more invested in the system. So it's too frightened to listen, and it's still pouring outside. And it's still pouring outside. This story is old. Come tomorrow, a train will take me home to await the next party who will appear to land in here. To my fears, hopes, vanity, loneliness, and frailty, and it's pouring outside. Then I couldn't ask for better weather. She lay by my side, and all I can do is forget her, and I'm torn up inside. As it rains like cats and dogs, maybe there'll be better weather next time. Someday.
Very good, man. Very good. Jeff was actually pointing out. Welcome, Jeff. By the way, I saw you.
Hello, Jeff.
JD Loveland. I'm like, oh, that's not JD.
Howdy.
Howdy, man. So
welcome, Jeff, back.
Yeah, welcome.
Good to see you again.
Jeff had actually pointed out, Rich. What's your sound settings set at? Do you have original sound turned on and like high fidelity music mode and all that fun stuff? Because your guitar.
I need to turn my original sound on.
Yeah. Do that.
Yeah, it's all on. It's just that I have to use the mic on the computer because I don't have a.
Hey, Rich.
I'm at work. Hey.
Gotcha. I just learned the Yiddish word for transsexual.
It's is boy- it pastrami?
Oichik.
Oichik.
Yo.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Let's move on, people.
That's right. Dan, you're going
to
be.
We all wanted to know that.
That's right. You know,
all right.
Always got, you know, random factoids coming from our friend over there in the Spoo Willoughby land.
Yeah, let's move on. Okay, so it was Mother's Day on Sunday.
It was.
And I surprised my mom with her favorite song I learned.
Awesome. What is it, Dan?
It's a Barry Manilow song. Because my mom is the biggest Barry Manilow fan in the world.
Play it for her live?
Biggest. She's seen him like 12 times and gone backstage every time. Mm-hmm. They're very, you know, they're very close. Her music means his music means a lot to her.
Yeah.
And you know, it's been kind of a learning, kind of a growing experience for me, because when I was growing up, I didn't appreciate Barry Manilow's music as much as I kind of do now. Sure. There's really some great songs like "Could It Be Magic?" That's an amazing song.
Yeah,
and a bunch of others. And this one is very very special to her. And I'll play it for you right now. It's called "Home Again." How's my guitar?
Sounding good so far, man.
How's the voice? Okay, great.
I would kind of stay back from your microphone to make it mix a little bit better.
Stay back.
Yeah. Yep. I think you'll be good like that. Your guitar sounds
okay, great.
Your voice sounds great.
By the way, I played a four hour show on Facebook Live last night.
What?
I can't believe it either. I'm never doing that again for like 4 hours.
I don't know if I ever got that notification. I would have tuned in.
Oh, Rob, you are you my friend on Facebook, Rob?
I am.
Okay.
So I don't get it.
That's weird. Okay, well, next time I'm live, I'll send you a message on Facebook Messenger.
Thanks. That'd be cool. Awesome.
Yeah, sure. Yeah,
I just didn't remember.
No, I don't think I send you anything. But yeah, I'm going to do it every Monday, I think, until I get tired of it.
4 hours?
four hours? No, never 4 hours again. Never.
What time did you start?
Two and a half, 3 hours. That's doable, but 4 hours. Oh my God. Everybody, there was like requests out the wazoo. I swear.
That's pretty cool though. Yeah. What time did you start at night? Was it like 8 o'clock, 6 o'clock? What time did you start?
9 o'clock.
Wow, so you're up like late. You're up till 1.
1 o'clock, yeah.
To my friend Darren, he always requests the same songs every time, The Boxer or Vienna by Billy Joel, and he's a pain in the ass.
Oh, Vienna. They're both amazing songs.
They're both amazing songs, but he's the way he when he requests songs, and I hope I hope he's not listening to this YouTube.
Okay. Well, here's Home Again by Barry Manilow. Whoop, I messed it up already. Okay, here we go. Let's try it again. And always now, when there was just one, there'll be two, and you won't be alone again. I'm home again. Over and over now, we'll make up for nights that we miss and kiss like we once kissed again. I'm home again. Close your eyes, I'll close my. We once had, and babe, I'm so glad to be home again. Love you, I love you now. There's no one but you in my life, and I won't let you go again. I'm home again. Close your eyes, I'll close my heart. Remember how much we once had, and babe, I'm so glad to be home again. I love you.
else in my life, and I won't let you go again. I'm home again, I'm home again, I'm home again. Yes, I'm
great.
It's a very obscure song.
When did he record
it? He's on his second record, the one that broke him with the song Mandy on it.
Oh, cool. Well,
yes, it's on Barry Manilow 2. That's the one.
And that's the song's called Home Again.
Yes. Well, actually, maybe it's on a later one. It's not.
No, it's on Manilow 2. Barry Manilow.
It's on Manilow 2? Okay. Right. Yeah.
That's so funny.
So there you go. That's
job, dude. That was well sung, well played.
Yeah.
It's a very complex chord structure. It's complex chord progression. So
played it well, Dan.
Yeah, man.
Thank you.
Yeah, it sounded really good, man. Good for you.
Thanks.
That was for my mom. What a great little tribute, you know, and dedication of that song to her. That's great for Mother's Day. What a great gift. I mean, you're showing me up, man. I called my mom and wished her happy Mother's Day. I didn't play her a song. Like, I got to show my mom some more appreciation here, man. Love you, Mom.
I didn't call my mother.
That's right. Nice job, Mike, though, man.
I didn't call my mother.
He said.
That's a terrible joke. Sorry to hear that. And to all those that are not able to appreciate their moms, God bless their hearts. Anyway.
Yeah.
Sorry to hear that, Mike. You're such an asshole.
I didn't like her anyway.
Oh, God, stop. You got to stop. Okay. You guys are killing me tonight, man. Right. You guys are killing me. Now, this is, you know.
So happy belated Mother's Day to.
That's right, to all the great moms out there, and the people that also become moms, you know, due to raising children that they might not have to or wanted to in the beginning. So.
And the ones who own pets too.
Yeah, that's right. The fur parents, the fur moms.
The fur pets. Yes.
I'm sorry, the pets own us.
Well, yeah, that's true.
Buy me food, clean my shit.
Banksy has the roost. Okay, anyway.
No, great job, Dan. That was really a great performance, man.
Yeah.
Vernon Tanjay, you are up next. And then Marty, her debut is on deck. Vernon, you want to play us a tune?
Oh, yeah, I was going to play this song. I wrote it. It was for the woman who became the future ex Spoo Willoughby. Mrs. X. But I had the idea in my head, but it turned out I had to make a new tuning in order to make it work. So this is a weird tuning I made up. She won't ride her bike when winter winds blow wrong. She don't like the hike, but the girl that I like locks her bike until the April thaw. Oh, the girl I like wears corduroy when snowflakes start to fall. There's no two alike, but the girl that I like doesn't like the snow at all. Once while looking around, this heart I found in a trash bin, much to my dismay. If you come across it, keep it or toss it, you can see it's a ridiculous design. In her eyes of green, there's a portent of spring, and there's a sweet September in her smile. But when she puts on that ridiculous hat, I know winter will linger for a while. Oh, the girl I adore says she cannot endure the New Year's frigid air. Oh, she just shivers and cries under overcast sky, pulls on her wings. Oh God. Once while looking around, this heart I found in a trash bin, much to my dismay. If you come across it, keep it or toss it, you can see ridiculous design. Like cellophane and window pane, some things are too obvious to see. Take this heart from my chest, hold it up to your breast. Let me see what it looks like next to thine. What I am trying to say in my idiotic way, that heart you hold is no longer. Something like that.
Yeah. Hey, Spoo.
That was awesome, man.
Mm-hmm.
Good job, Vern. Very well done. I know you're probably, you know, pushing through that, you know, but what kind of tuning did you actually have? Was it, you know, just something very obscure, or what do you got?
I think Hawaiians might use it.
Hawaiians? But,
the two fat strings I change the low E down to C.
Okay, wow. Yeah.
And then the A down to G. So you got a C and a G down there.
Interesting. Very that cool, is man. I like that. Yeah, I don't really experiment with different tunings like that often. If anything, I just do maybe like a half step down so everything's flat, or like a drop D. That's basically
the only way it would work for me.
Gotcha.
That's the tuning that Richard Thompson uses for the 52 Vincent Black Lightning song.
Really?
Very interesting.
Really?
Cool.
Richard Thompson, huh?
Richard Thompson does that. Drops the low E down to C and the A down to G.
Yeah. Very awesome.
There you go. Richard Thompson, nice compliment there.
Yeah, right.
Jay was my wife's boss.
Oh, I was going to say, how many times were you married?
Just the once.
That's what I figured. Yeah.
Once and
done.
Does
she know
about
that song?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. She knows about the song.
She knows about that.
No, she doesn't.
You played it at my house in front of her. And at the end of the song, you said, I still didn't get laid.
Oh, that's amazing. You know, heartbreak and exes do really generate a lot of great musical content. I've written a lot of songs that way. So,
yes, that's true.
No doubt. Awesome. Well, thanks so much, Vernon. Hey, so we've got a great treat tonight. Our debut party is going to be happening. Come on. I mean, let's all get excited and give her a round of applause for obtaining the courage.
Love Marty.
Yeah. Oh, I'm so happy.
You can do it.
Oh, don't be embarrassed. You're good.
Yeah, don't be. I've been waiting for this day forever.
I'm not Cindy or Rachel or Lily, but I'll
Well, you're Marty, and we wouldn't want you to be like them at all because you
That's
are you.
That's right. You're Marty.
Amen, Chad.
That's right.
Well, this is dedicated to all you guitar players out there. I mean, I've always been a big Brett fan. My daughter and I listened to the whole album when I went over there the other day. I got all my albums out, and it just brings back so many memories. I love Brett.
Aww.
But I hope you can hear this. Let me see.
Yeah, let's do a little sound check here for you. And you know what? We might actually want to go through.
Is that too loud?
Yeah, it's probably going to be fine depending how loud you're going to sing. Let's go through your audio settings, though, real quick, Marty, if you don't mind. Are you on a computer or a phone?
I'm on a tablet. And my phone's playing on my Bluetooth, my speakers.
It might have it.
Would it sound better without these?
Oh, no. Yeah, keep that. So whatever is giving us your audio input, which is probably your tablet, it sounds fine.
Seems okay to me.
It is, but let's try it because we've never done Marty's sound and to give her the fan.
Right. Okay. Yeah, we'll set it up.
Let's go through it, Marty.
All right, was that all right or the other way?
Yeah, just keep it as is. Let's not even worry about it yet until we update the sound settings. Okay. Can you do that with me real quick?
Okay.
Okay. So what we're gonna do is with your tablet, and that's how we're hearing you, right? And that's how your microphone input is. Okay, I think it is. So what you're going to do is you're going to go on your tablet and you see where your mute button is? There's like a little up arrow, like a little carrot. Do you see that?
No, in my tablet? No.
Yep.
I'm one of these dummies that don't know this.
Oh, you'll be fine. Don't worry. I'll guide you. Okay, so do you see the mute button? Is there a mute button on the tablet?
Mute button, yeah, right here. It's on my bottom.
Okay, is there like a little like itty bitty carrot next to it or no?
No, carrot.
How about like an icon where it says like settings or like a gear shape or something like that?
Share participants more. Nope.
Okay, let me bring up the Zoom. I'll bet you have an app that you're using on your tablet. Let me go in here real quick. Just give me a moment. It won't take long. Just give me a second.
Chad. Marty came to my karaoke night, and she had good sound then, so maybe we should just let her do it.
That's fine by me. Whatever you want to do, Marty. Do you want to go as is, or
I did it that night?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, with the TV. Okay.
It sounded kind of balanced.
Yeah, that's fine. I just, you know, if those settings are there and it makes you sound better, I'd want to be fair and, you know, update them. But let's go. If you guys want to go, I'm all for it.
Okay.
It doesn't matter to me. I'm just right.
We can do it. We can do it next time. Next time she comes, like early. You know?
Yeah, I don't think it'll take that long, but that's okay.
Is that good? How's that?
I mean, we can hear it, Marty. So what we need to do is like hear you sing to it to see if it's balanced or not. So go ahead.
Okay.
Who draws the crowd and plays so loud? Baby, it's a guitar man. Who's gonna steal the show? You know, baby, it's a guitar man. He can make you love, he can make you cry. He will bring you down and he'll get you high. Something keeps him going. night after night, who treats you right, baby, it's a guitar man. Who's on the radio, you go and listen to the guitar man. And then he comes to town, you'll see his face. And you think you might like to take his place. Something keeps him drifting miles and miles away, searching for the songs to play. Then you listen to the music and you like to sing along. You want to get the meaning out of each and every song. Then you find yourself a message and some words you call your own and take them home.
Excellent.
Very cool, Marty.
Very
nice.
Cool. And a very nice tribute to all the guitar men and women out there.
That's right.
Heck yeah. No, I wish we would have heard you sooner, but I'm glad the day has come. Very
that was
nice
so great.
Job. Very nice job.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Bet. All right. Now with Marty making her debut, we're going to have Lily come up and play us a tune. And then on deck, we've got Cindy Cowan. How's it going, Lily?
It's going pretty good. How's it going with you?
Oh, it's going.
Oh,
well.
Great! Welcome back. We love hearing you. So
yeah,
I mean,
absolutely. And you have like a whole band back there. I saw you playing your flute. I saw you playing the keyboard. You got a drum set. I mean, what are you gonna be playing for us tonight? And with what instruments? Maybe.
Well, I'm not that kind of multi instrumentalist. I've got an original that I'm going to be playing on the piano.
Awesome. All right.
That's great.
I'm going to take a moment before I start playing to plug my music. You can find me on like Spotify and all streaming services as Red Linen Antlers.
Red Linen Antlers. All right. I like that.
If you see it on Spotify, there's two playlists on the page. One of music that's I'm proud of. And then there's another one of music that's not to be listened to. It's not because I'm not proud of it. It's because it's hardly music. Mostly like weird psychedelic sound experiments. Just don't listen if you don't want to have a panic attack.
Okay, that makes me want to listen. That makes me want to listen even more now. Even more.
I'll be back in a few minutes, everybody.
No. Although if you have a panic attack, just give me a call. I'll work with you.
That's right. Yeah, you can give Mike
talk you down.
Well,
take
I'm
it away, Lily.
Yeah, go for it.
I think my audio settings are good. I checked them. So let's see.
Go ahead.
Yeah, you know, sometimes I need some space. But you've opened up my world. I hope you feel it too. It's amazing, and so are you. Time apart, that's okay. I will just love you from a distance. And when you're ready, I'll be here with open arms. I ponder if there is a drug that could compare to the way I feel looking in your eyes. If someday they find one, honestly, I don't want none. You're my love plug, babe. I'm hooked on your supply.
And assuming it was a bit loud.
No, it was actually a good mix.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, it was a good mix.
Yeah, no, it's good. An original, and we can find that on Spotify.
Not yet. I'm in the process of recording though. This is a public debut.
Oh, that's
debut.
So great.
Oh wow.
Yeah. Well, no, absolutely. Really, yeah, keep going.
You know, it's nobody. You know, it would be great. You know, if songs like that were still heard on the radio. I like that kind of music.
No, there's a lot of great music that doesn't get played on the radio, and yeah, you know, that absolutely. You have to find, that
all
you have to dig,
there's all
dig
kinds
around
of radio.
And
sounds like my favorite psychedelic kind of 80s. Yeah. Kind
if it's
of
if it's any consolation, I don't necessarily plan to be commercially viable.
I hear you.
That's a good way of setting expectations up realistically. So, and then if you do, you're like, oh, great.
Now, speaking of psychedelic, is there something, or was it just me? Was there something changing the color of the lights behind you while you were playing?
I have an LED
yes.
light strip on the ceiling.
Oh, yep. Nice.
Just I live in a basement, and having the lights constantly changing kind of makes me feel like I'm in my own little psychedelic paradise world. And,
yes.
and
nice.
I'm not anywhere else. I'm not in my father's basement.
I should put on my disco light.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, and then you can get that experience sans the psilocybin or. You know. Whatever you like to do psychedelically. Anyway, great song.
I want to say, Lily. I met Lily at the Dovetail first when she was hosting open mic.
Back when
and
I was a boy.
Yeah.
I was bowled over. We kind of bonded over talking about music and stuff.
About Billy Joel and, specifically. You're the only person I've ever known to rival my knowledge of Billy Joel.
No shit. Cool. Yeah.
I don't have everything. You know, I don't have fantasies and delusions.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I don't.
Novice.
I know. I'm ashamed. But thank you so much, Lily, for coming. And
yeah.
I'm just thrilled that you're here. And I hope you can come back again.
Oh, soon. Come back.
I'll try and come back next week.
Absolutely. Please, that was awesome. That was a really good performance. Really good song.
Thank you.
Yeah. So Cindy, you're up next.
I am.
Glad to see you. Is your camera on?
Thank
or
you.
Off? Where are you
it's
at?
It's off and I need it that way. I hope
okay.
people aren't offended by that.
Oh, no, I'm not. I was just curious to see if you know. That's all.
I do know and I'm so happy to join all of you tonight.
Absolutely. No, that's all I need to hear. No, there's no shame in this game. We're all welcome-ing however you want to be, cameraless or you can
Thank you. I just can't do it tonight, but
is it just because you're performing naked? Is that why?
No, that's part of the reason, but I don't want to give too much away. You know,
Mike, we're gonna have to
the best, you know.
Mike, we're gonna have if you keep that up, we're gonna have to boot you, man. We're gonna have to boot you.
I'm sorry. She's your sister. My apologies.
That's true. That's true.
No, all in good fun and love.
That's
and
right.
All right.
Got my eye on you.
Okay. This is by Ingrid Michaelson. I did do something with her and Sarah Bareilles before, but this is one of her original singles, and I just think it's a cool little song. So
awesome. Go ahead, take it away, Cindy.
All right. Oh, oops.
I don't know if your music is going to go up really low.
I forgot to unplug my Bluetooth speaker from the charger. Amateur. Sorry.
Oh, that's all right.
All right. Let's try this again.
You think real open mics go smooth?
There we go. I don't believe in anything but myself. I don't believe in anything but myself. But then you opened up a door. You opened up a door. Now I start to believe in something else. But how do I know if I'll make it through? How do I know where's the proof in you? And so it goes, this soldier knows, the battle with the heart isn't easily won. And so it goes, this soldier knows, the battle with the heart isn't easily won, but it can be won. But it can be won. I sit in the back of the bus, watching the world grow old, watching the world go by all by myself. I took a faithful leap and packed up all my things and all my love and gave it to somebody else. But how do I know if I'll make it through? How do I know where's the proof in you? And so it goes, this soldier knows, the battle with the heart isn't easily won. And so it goes, this soldier knows, the battle with the heart isn't easily won, but it can be won. 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 And so it goes, this soldier knows, the battle with the heart isn't easily won. And so it goes, this soldier knows, the battle with the heart isn't easily won. And so it goes, this soldier knows, the battle with the heart isn't easily won. And so it goes, this soldier knows, the battle with the heart isn't easily won. But it can be won. But it can be won.
Thank you.
Wow.
I like it.
That's an interesting song.
Voice.
I like your, like, I think they call it staccato, like where it's like,
yeah,
it's a weird kind of way that she sings the lyrics. They sort of go against the beat a little bit, and it's kind of challenging. So I tried to mimic that song with that.
Yeah, cool. I love like different ways of, you know, using your voice dynamically like that. So great job.
Thanks.
Great job.
Thank
great
job.
You.
Yes.
Awesome. Yeah, you're always teaching me new songs and new artists.
Awesome. You guys too.
Yeah, I know a lot of people.
Yeah, we're all teaching each other in different music and new music.
That's right. All right. Well, thank you, Cindy. Tom,
I want to welcome Karen.
Oh yeah. Yeah, no, we do want to do that.
Hi Karen. No, just we were trying to contact you in chat. Are you going to perform tonight? Would you like to perform? Great.
Is she?
Yes.
Yes, that's a yes.
Oh, cool. All right, Karen. Well, great. I'll get you on the list. Awesome. Welcome.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I was muted.
Oh, no, you're fine.
That's okay.
I was doing some multiple things here, and I just didn't see you shaking your head. Cool.
Well, yeah, Karen's my friend who I invited.
Yeah, awesome. Yeah, very cool. Glad to have you. Can't wait to hear you perform. So up next, we've got Tom Senrud, and then after him, we've got Steve Phelps, the Memphis Hawk himself. What's up, Tom? How are you, man?
Good. Thanks, everybody. It's nice to be here. Can I get a sound check before I start?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead and give me a strum and a little, you know, la-di-da-di-dee, la-di-da-di-die, or whatever you're missing. Yep, your sound sounds good. I mean, I hear...
All right. You're muted.
Sorry, I mean, I can hear like a little bit of a high-pitched like whine or whatever, but I think it's that microphone or whatever, but it's fine. It's a lot better than what you had before, so you're all good.
All right, thanks.
Yep, go ahead.
I'm going to try and do this. I think David Bowie wrote this song, but then Kurt Cobain of Nirvana did The Man Who Sold the World, so I was going to try and do that. So here goes. Thank you.
Ben.
Nice, Tom.
Yeah, man, that was great.
Thanks, Chris.
Good guitar playing, good you know, good singing. It's a good song too, man. We've heard of that a lot actually on our little get together and whatnot. A lot of people play that song, but I love hearing it every time.
Thank you.
Yeah, man, nice job. All right, the Memphis Hawk is up next, and then we've got
Memphis
on deck
Hawk in the house.
Yeah, then we've got on deck Jeff Schmitz.
Made a bunch of money.
How you going? How's it going, Steve?
Yeah, how are you, man?
Uh-oh. Can you say something to Mike? Uh-oh. We can't hear you.
Can you go bye-bye?
Yeah.
Where is he?
Hello?
Yeah, okay, we can hear you now.
There you are.
Weird. Okay, so you can hear that now?
We can hear you now.
Yeah.
Okay. How about the guitar?
Sounds a little low.
Quiet?
Let me get the headphones on here. Yeah, it sounds a little low to me, but hang on.
I kept it the same as last week. For some reason, it's not as loud this week, huh?
Yeah. Your guitar is really low, actually. Now that I have the headphones on.
Yeah.
Yeah, you want to bring that up a little bit, Steve. Go ahead and take the time. It won't take too long. You got like 5 minutes.
It almost sounds like the guitar is muted if it's supposed to be plugged in. Like the only sound is coming through the vocal mic.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Really?
Yeah.
You're not hearing any.
And wow, Jeff. Jeff, compared to you, Steve, Jeff has quite a volume.
More pronounced, yeah.
Interesting. All right.
Now,
that's better. That's better now.
Yeah. Let's do one thing. We've had this happen before. I've done this many times. I'm a Zoom audio expert now. So let's just look at your audio input and let's just see if the gain in Zoom is set to auto. We've been finding that people is really well set. So let's go into and change that manually and set that to a gain that's proper for
okay. Where do I do that at in the Zoom?
Yeah, so what you're going to do is you're going to go down to your bottom left-hand corner. You see that mute button, and then you have that little carrot there?
I don't have that.
Oh, you don't? Are you using an iPad?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. You know what? Go look at these. You see these little screenshots that I posted in the chat for Marty? Here, you know what? Don't do anything. Check this out.
I don't see any pictures that you posted.
I know. Here, just. no, I'm not going to be able to share my actual screen because I can't share the Zoom then. All right, never mind. I thought I was going to blow your minds. Okay, so what I'm going to tell you to do is in your Zoom app, there should be a... Hang on, let me bring this back here. Where is the... Now I can't stop sharing my screen, of course. I'm trying to show off here, and now I'm getting stuck. in your Zoom app, though, there should be a settings button. Do you see that at the bottom when you go back out of the meeting?
When I go back out of the meeting?
Yeah, because it's not on the bottom, and now I can't get out of here.
I think I'm a lost cause here because when I don't want to leave the meeting.
Yeah, you shouldn't have to leave it, though. There should just be, like, a back button. It's all right. It's really hard to explain when I don't have it up there to show you and, like, go through it, and now I can't get back into the meeting for whatever reason. Okay,
here. Gotcha.
Now I see. So,
if you can't hear, there's no point in me doing it, though, I wouldn't think.
Yeah, we can hear you. It's just really low.
Okay. Yeah, it's weird because last week I did the same thing with the same settings, and it worked, but...
All right,
The mic is a good volume.
Right.
Can you turn up the guitar? Can you turn up the guitar?
All maxed out.
It's all maxed out. Okay.
All maxed out. Like I said, last week this was fine, and this week it's.
May I suggest that you just pull the microphone down so it's picking up the guitar a little bit better, and split the mic between the guitar and the voice?
Yeah, I can do that.
That sounds like a good compromise. Yeah.
Jeff, you're better at this than me, man. I think you've done this once or twice before.
All right, how's that then?
Yeah, that's good. I mean, it'll work.
Unforgiven land meets the evening tide.
missing love. Where's the breaking? The breaking sun. We're so lost in the wake of the kingdom come.
Memphis Hawk.
Thank you.
That was great. The good that was a good suggestion, Jeff. That worked.
Cool deal.
Yeah, I mean, worst comes to worst, I can use a different microphone to grab a condenser mic that's going to pick up more of a wide range too, and just kind of do both. I was trying to be cute, trying to use a different setup, but didn't work.
Sometimes it doesn't. Yeah, sometimes it just doesn't work quite like you wanted to, but that was great, man. That was great.
Yeah, we'll just have to get you guys some better instructions too. I mean, putting some cool videos together so people can prepare and have this. Like, I don't usually use it on an app, so it's so easy for me just to use it. But Windows.
Yeah, I didn't think there used to be a fix on tablets either. Is that kind of new?
There is. Yeah, I looked it up. And if you look in the chat, I don't know if you can get there, Steve. There should be a way for you to look at those pictures that I had sent through the chat. And
all I see in here is that Marty. Take these three steps for enabling, and then nothing.
And then nothing. No shit. Okay. Because I sent files. Okay. Don't worry about it.
You
now.
Send them directly to somebody rather than to everyone, maybe?
No, they're there. I can see them.
Yeah.
I can't see them.
Because he's probably
see everyone else. I just don't see those pictures.
That's all right. We'll put together a post with, you know, directions and stuff. Because it really is, you know, and I want people to understand. Because it does make a difference. It really does.
You should do a video tutorial of this.
Absolutely. 100%.
Yeah, we did.
We can all, you could send us your link and we could all learn at our own pace.
Absolutely.
Chris did one earlier when the settings weren't, before the settings were changed.
Yeah.
So we might have to do another one.
We do. Yeah. Zoom has evolved. It really has. And that's
unfortunately, and it keeps evolving.
It does. Yeah.
In a good way, though. In a good way, because it's focusing more on sound.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is true. I mean, when we first started using it, we had a lot of trouble with I had the free version. My guitar wasn't loud enough. And,
right.
You know, now I got Chad fixed my microphone. So.
Yeah, it picks up now. It picks up loud. No, this is good. We'll figure it out, though. We'll help you guys out.
And yeah, we'll figure it out. We'll figure it out.
Anyway, without further ado, we've got Jeff Schmitz up next, and then Bob Hausler, you're going to be on deck. Jeff, thanks for your help thus far, and what are you going to be playing for us tonight?
Well, let me ask a question. Didn't I see in from Dan that it was supposed to be show tune night, or is that coming up?
That's actually in a week from today. So
okay. So Tuesday, so, yeah, May 8th. So I'm not going to do the song that I had.
You can.
I'll save that for
unless you're coming next week.
Yeah. Well,
sorry for the mix-up. If there was
no problem. No problem. I'm just going to reset here for a different song.
Yeah, you're fine.
Because
man.
I don't know that many show tunes, so I don't want to.
Yeah, you don't want to be the one hit and quit it, huh?
Yeah, exactly. Here we go. I think.
Oh yeah, we can hear some effects going on there. I like the reverb in the surround there. Nice.
Disappear without love. Where would you be now without love? North Central and the Southern set you free. Keep on pushing, mama.
Like missing your intro and having to, I had to eliminate the guitar solo to get the track back online.
Oh, gotcha.
And what's worse about that is I recorded it myself, so I can't blame anybody.
Dude, it sounded great though. I mean, honestly, it sounded like really like good quality in my headphones, like surrounding and stuff. Like the effects were great, the beat was great. Awesome job, man.
Yeah, thanks a lot for coming again, Jeff.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Don't bang down on yourself too hard, man. That was
it was acceptable. Please plug your open mic.
Yeah.
Oh, well, we do a Friday night open mic in out of San Diego. So for all you East Coast people, it's real late. We go from about 6 to 8, 8:30
yep.
on Pacific time. And it's on the virtual music group. So if you want to join the virtual music group on Facebook, you'll get all the calendars and updates and invitations and all that kind of stuff.
Awesome.
Very and cool. I just happen to be playing at his open mic on Friday. So
oh,
I'm
no
excited
way.
About that. I did it last time too. Jeff fit me in and I went last after this amazing guy, Vic from yeah. UK. He was like, I'm like, what? I have to follow that.
Yeah. Well, Dan, I maybe should have warned you, but you know, what we do is I try to save a little bit of time at the end of the show in case the show goes long. And if not, I usually don't play unless there's somebody drops out or something like that. So I don't know. Okay. Well, you know, hey, Dan's here. Let's invite him in. And then after I invited you, and I was like, you know, I am sticking him after Vic, and I try to put Vic last.
He's that good. No,
yeah. So if both of you are saying that he's that good, he must be phenomenal. Like to hear.
I invited him. He's. Oh yeah. Go ahead.
You know, he's from Cambridge, in the UK, you know, outside of London, and so when he comes to join us, he's up at 3 a.m. playing for us.
Oh yeah, awesome. Yeah.
He is just fantastic. You haven't even heard half of it, Dan. Wait till you hear some of his real incredible fingerstyle stuff.
I want to come now. I mean, you guys are really hyping this guy up. I want to see Vic and you, Dan. But honestly, Vic sounds like he's the shit. I mean, honestly,
I'm hoping that Vic comes here because he's part of the he's part of our group now. He's part of our Facebook group.
Oh, cool.
I welcomed him and I sent him an invitation tonight. Yeah, I just hope that he comes sometime, you know, some week. Some Tuesday, that'd be great.
Yeah, awesome. No, awesome. Yeah, thanks for plugging the open mic night. And yeah, we'll definitely have to attend.
Thank you, Jeff.
Yeah, man, thank you so much. All right, so next up we've got Bob Hausler and Karen Weaver is going to be on deck. Bob, how are you, man?
Good, how about yourself, Chad?
I am doing well, my friend. What do you got to play for us tonight?
I don't really have anything.
Oh, come on. Well, you got your guitar in your lap, and I saw you playing, so I'll bet you're
fooling. I love playing along with everybody. That's
I know. Yeah, I was doing that a little bit now, too. Yeah, it was fun.
I'll do a short little thing of a old Beatles tune.
Cool. Yeah, take it away, man. Thank you.
nice.
That was phenomenal, Bob.
Wow, that sucked.
Phenomenal.
Sorry, man. I was clapping, but I forgot I was still on the other window when I was trying to unmute.
No,
that was sweet.
Yeah, Bob, that was great, man. Don't be so, you know, we're always so hard on ourselves, but it was phenomenal, dude. It was great. It was great.
Fabulous.
Great.
Wow. Yeah. Thank you for playing.
Sorry, Bob.
Aaron, you're going to be our one and only act here, the main event. You ready?
Your one and only act.
I don't know. I'm losing my words, and I must be getting tired.
The headliner.
That's what I'm looking for. The headliner.
The grand finale. But we're going around again. We're going around again. We go around again.
Yeah, I guess I should be more clear with the rules and whatnot. Yeah, so everybody's taking a song per turn. You are the last on the list, and yes, you are the headliner. So thank you for filling in it. My mad libs. You guys are getting me in there.
The song I'm going to do is very different than what he just played. Black Velvet.
Oh, nice. Very cool.
Yeah, it's a great song.
I'm a soul girl, so.
Yeah, bring down the house.
Yeah, my last band used to do that a lot.
Black Velvet.
Can you hear it okay?
Oh, if you're playing the music now, no, we cannot.
No.
You can't hear the music?
No.
Okay. Just barely.
Yeah, okay, I hear maybe hear the crash of the cymbals, maybe with the drums.
Let me hire it.
Mm-hmm.
What's your setup, Karen?
Yeah. Do you have a Bluetooth?
I've got my laptop and a Bluetooth speaker.
Okay.
Okay.
Perfect. Can you hear it better now?
It's getting there. I would
better.
I would raise it up a little bit more.
Higher.
Yeah. Or... Can you?
Yep.
Yeah. Can you? You know, that's good.
Is that good?
Yeah.
That'll do.
Are you sure?
Yeah, it's pretty good. What? I mean, could you make it a little bit louder?
Based on her voice, it could be louder.
It could be louder. Yeah,
well,
I would
see,
go louder.
The thing is, I live in an apartment building, so.
Oh.
There you go. If that's as loud as you can have.
I know how that feels. I was trying to play my saxophone, and my neighbors upstairs knocked on the door. I was doing my open mic and tried to play my saxophone, and she wasn't.
Right. Okay, so Karen, you do what feels comfortable to you. Okay.
Absolutely.
That's good. That's good.
Rock it out, Karen. You got it.
Okay, I'm just going to do one song tonight then.
Sure.
Mississippi in the middle of a dry spell. Jimmy Rogers on a Victrola up high. Mama's dancing with a baby on her shoulder. The sun is setting like molasses in the sky. The boy could sing, knew how to move everything. Always wanting more. Hey, they be longing for black velvet in that little boy's smile. Black velvet with that soul southern style. A new religion that'll bring you to your knees. Black velvet, if you please. Well, up in Memphis, the music's like a heat wave. Oh, I started. I'm not sure. Sorry, this karaoke thing was going all over the place on the lyrics for me. Hold on. The way he moved, it was a sin, so sweet and true. Always wanting more. Hey, leave you longing for black velvet in that little boy's smile. Black velvet with that slow southern style. A new religion that'll bring you to your knees. Black velvet. Every word of every song that he sang was for you. You. In a flash, he was gone. It happened so soon. What could you do? Black velvet and that little boy's smile. Black velvet with that slow southern style. New religion that'll bring you up to your knees. Black velvet, if you please. Black velvet and that little boy's smile. Black velvet with that slow southern style. New religion that'll bring you up to your knees. Black velvet. If you please, if you please, if you please. If you please, that's it.
Yeah.
Thank you. I need to find like a different like karaoke.
I think you did great. You had the attitude, you know.
It happened to me the other night. Like yeah. The second verse in the songs, I need to find another karaoke video. Like it hits the karaoke video. It hits the words at the wrong time, and I think yeah. I'm off when I'm not. You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
When
you find them on YouTube, sometimes they'll actually be like weird like that. I've done it with a few friends. Yeah. Yep.
You'll be going faster than you can hear. Well, wait a minute.
Yeah, yeah, it's off. It's off sometimes. Yeah.
Oh, you did great, though, Karen. That was fantastic. Yeah, definitely.
That was excellent, Karen.
If we can get back around to you, we're going to move fast because it is 10 o'clock.
Yeah, we got to move fast.
I know. I'm going to skip my turn. Rob, would you like to play us another song? And then, Rachel, you're going to be on.
Yeah. I think that I'm going to play and then I'm going to hit the because it's getting late, but I just want to plug it one more time because I forgot to when I was plugging my open mic. It's from 8 to 10 Eastern time Friday night, so you have a lot of time, I guess, if you want to head on. If you go to Jeff's, head on down to mine first.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, that's right. You guys are you have the simultaneous Friday night events, and actually
mine was on Thursday, but I found Friday nights was better for me and better for everyone.
Oh, cool. Okay, man. Well, yeah, if you want, definitely give us another song then. Thanks for playing.
I will. I'm going to do my last song, and I'm going to – but everybody's been wonderful tonight, and I enjoyed everything.
Yeah, man.
Thank you so much for coming, Rob.
Yeah, thanks,
You're
Rob.
You're welcome.
Thanks for sharing your appreciation to our performers. I think they are pretty fantastic. Heck, yeah.
Oh, they are. They are really pretty – every one of you. I'm going to do Foo Fighters.
Cool.
Foo Fighters tune. It's called Miracle. Whoops. Oh, here we go. Crazy, but crazy, but I'm relieved this time. Begging for sweet relief, a blessing in disguise. dying behind these tired eyes. I've been losing sleep. Please come to me tonight. Hands on a miracle. I got my hands on a miracle. Believe it or not, hands on a miracle, and there ain't no way let you take it away. Everything that we survive, it's gonna be alright, just lucky we're alive. Got no vision, I've been blind, searching everywhere, you're right here in my side. Hands on a miracle. I got my hands on a miracle. Believe it or not, hands on a miracle. And there ain't no way let you take it away. Hands on a miracle. I got my hands on a miracle. Believe it or not, hands on a miracle. I got my hands on a miracle, and there ain't no way let you take it away. Let you take it away.
Good job, Rob.
Thank you.
Excellent. Great cover.
Thank you.
I felt the emotion.
Yeah. I like to put emotion in my song. So I'm going to be, but before I go, I'm hoping to see some of you on Friday night for Kenny Loggins Nights.
Kenny Loggins night. Oh, okay.
Hey, Dan, you put that you were coming.
Well, I thought it was Thursday.
No, it's I moved it to Friday because I don't know.
Well, I can't make it. I'm gonna be on Jeff's. Well, I don't know. We'll
Jeff's open mic is at what time and it's Pacific, right?
Yeah. We'll see. We'll see.
So it would be what?
I'll see if I can make both.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
The group is called.
Yeah. Plug your open mic. Plug your open mic, Rob.
Okay. I do also go live on Facebook and record to the cloud now. So it's Unity and Melody virtual online open mic with me, Rob C. And I can put it in the message group if you want.
Yeah,
that would be great.
And then you can join, and then I'll add you as a friend so that you can be on the message group, too.
Okay, sounds good.
All right, cool. And your name is?
Karen.
Karen. Oh, Dan's friend, Karen.
Yeah.
That was awesome tonight.
Black Velvet Karen.
Yeah, sure. I'll just add you, and then I'll invite you to the group, too. So, you're welcome. All right, you guys have a good night now.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you, Rob. You too.
Good night, Rob. Great to see you.
Night, Cindy. You too.
Night.
Night.
Awesome. That was a great performance.
All right.
Rachel?
Yes. Yes.
Awesome.
Rachel is up.
Yeah, Jay, you're going to be on deck.
I'm up.
Rachel, how are you going to wow us this time?
Well, the cabaret is getting weird.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. Oh, look at that hat. Oh, that's stylish.
Yeah.
I'm thinking about you. I'm thinking about Kurt Cobain. Thinking about Davy Jones. I mean, David Bowie. Mm-hmm. And I'm thinking about Fred Astaire. We passed upon the stair. We spoke of whys and when, although I wasn't there. He said I was his friend, which came as a surprise. I spoke into his eyes. I thought you died alone a long, long time ago. And he said, oh no, not me. I never lost control. Your face to face with the man who sold the world. Ah, it made me feel so good to know that. Heart beats so that I can hardly speak, and I seem to find the happiness I seek when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Heaven, I'm in heaven, and the cares that hung around me through the week vanish like a gambler's lucky streak when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Oh, I'd love to climb a mountain and reach the highest peak, but it doesn't thrill me half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. And I'd love to go off fishing in a river or a creek, but I don't enjoy it half as much as dancing cheek to cheek. Dance with me, I want your arms about me. You, the charms about you will carry me through to heaven. Yes, I'm in heaven, and my heart beats so that I can hardly speak. And I seem to find the happiness I seek when we're out together dancing cheek to cheek. Right, Kurt and Fred?
Rachel.
Your best.
I love that hat.
I love that hat too. Yeah.
Yeah, that's all you can say about that number. So I love that hat. What did that mean?
Well, oh God, no.
I take the compliment. I thank you.
You know you're good. You know you're good.
Good hat.
We don't have to tell you you're good. You know you're good.
But how cool was that? You got inspired to play.
Why? I don't know.
Come on, that's amazing.
So good, Rachel.
Yeah.
Thank you. I'm glad. I was so loving Tom coming in with it tonight. We're on the same plane. Why are we doing that?
Uh-huh.
But I butchered the lyrics, didn't I?
No, you did.
You're great.
So, thank you.
The music.
Thank you.
I mean, somebody put that medley together for you, basically, right? Or did I mean somebody did that for you, right? Or did you find that?
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, I put it together, and then I worked with my guitarist Matthew, who Dan knows because he plays with my ghost character, and
yeah.
I was complimented because he said another first, Rachel. I don't think these have ever put together before.
I would have
really interesting combination, that's for sure.
That song, it was well done. I mean, like, it's just so cool to hear different versions. We always joke that we want to play that everybody plays like the same song and they like do their own little thing
around it. So great.
Wasn't that going to be one of the ideas for the theme that we would do like one or and doing other people's original work?
That happened at the end of.
We all do the same song.
Yeah.
It's hysterical.
That happened at the end of John Prine Night. Everybody started playing Angel Montgomery.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It happens naturally. You guys are inspired by each other and stuff. It's so cool.
Yeah.
I love it. And it was phenomenal performance, Rachel, as always. Yes.
You know, so someday they may overcome the latency problems.
Yes. Someday though, you know.
I don't know. I wouldn't count there, but
in the near future, but you know, 5 years or less.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see about that.
Yeah, I put it together for a few large churches where they have things across town in different cities.
That's so cool.
But it's tough.
Yeah, we'll have to talk, man. It sounds like you have a lot of knowledge doing this, so I need to learn from you. For real.
Yeah, Jeff.
Yeah, man. So thank you, so much.
Thank you so much, Rachel.
So good. Jay, you're up next, and then Mike. Is he here? Is he still here?
Mike is gone.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you, Rachel.
Yeah.
That was Fred Astaire was kind of the David Bowie in his day, wasn't he?
Well, David Bowie dance? I mean, he kind of did.
He was a weirdo. He was a weirdo.
I don't remember Fred doing a lot of
that's for sure.
Yep.
Red cross dressing.
I'm not sure about that.
Yeah, I don't think so.
There was that one scene where he was in a baby's outfit in a bassinet with two other actors in the bandwagon.
Oh, my goodness. Don't really want. Well, yeah, that's pretty freaky.
Here's a song for all of you Catholic kids out there who went to Catholic school. If there's any of those out there, I have no idea. But this is this harkens back to a time when a young man with problems could go and get advice from his parish priest, you know. And nowadays, it has other implications sometimes. So much simpler times.
No doubt.
Father Sebastian, how are you? Can I take a moment of your time? Can I tell you about a friend of mine? A boy has this guy lost his way. His baby left him yesterday. Oh, will she come back to him, Father Sebastian? Her love meant so much to me. I mean him. Tell me, will he again?
What's the use? I guess you know it from the start. I confess I'm the one with the broken heart. A boy has this guy lost his way. My baby left me yesterday. Oh, will she come back to me, Father Sebastian? Father Sebastian. Father Sebastian.
Thank you.
Good job, Jay.
I have to tell a story about that after that song. But
is that a
parish priest?
Say again.
I have to tell a story about after that song about your. I when my son
well, you're
was
up,
ten.
You're up, Rich. So yeah,
wait,
you get to tell a story.
That's right.
So when my son was 10, we were on a family vacation to Rome, and we went on the tour of the Sistine Chapel, my son and I, and he got pissed off and ran off. And I figured I'd see him at the exit, but apparently there's two ways to leave the Sistine Chapel, and he went down one way and I went down the other. So I lost my son in the Vatican.
My goodness.
And we did find him eventually. A German couple found him and brought him to security. But when we were searching frantically for my 10-year-old boy, I went up to one of the Swiss guards and said, "Can you help us? My son has run off." And he literally said, "Sir, don't worry. What could happen to a small boy in the Vatican?"
Oh, no. Oh,
you got a son there.
Oh my God! No. So, hey Vern, remember that old sofa I had in the house? I got it thrown out today, and they had to cut it open to get it out the door, just to throw it out. And there was a dead bird in it. Was that yours?
Was that yours? What a question! What's the answer?
I don't know. It wasn't my bird.
Yeah, exactly.
How much money was in there?
I don't know. I don't ask about that. My son, the one who was lost in the Vatican, was there to help them out because I was here at work. Anyway, this song involves a bird.
A lost bird in the couch that was set for you finally by getting cut open.
No, it was being thrown out. It was like 1-800 got junk came by to pick up stuff. So
I got you, man. What were you gonna put?
I sit on a ceiling and watch myself sitting in the back of an old classroom, staring out the window at a crow. It laughs on a black branch, and now I'm that crow, staring through the window at the back row, at the kid who's now grown older. Ah, shit. Somebody's called me. Put the next one on, I'll sing in a minute. Sorry. Yes,
doctor. All right, that's amazing. So Rick,
Rich
is at work. When his phone rings.
Okay, so Rich, okay, so I'll go?
Yeah, Dan, you're up, man, you know?
Okay, I'll go.
When the man needs to take the call, we're gonna go to the next person.
Yeah, he's got an important job. So
it would be a PK.
Yep. We'll just go back to him then.
Very important job.
That's okay. Right.
Well, I'll try.
Go ahead, Dan.
Okay, so
it's awesome.
This is okay. Let me preface this with, I've been going through my old record collection.
lately. I've been kind of like taking a trip down memory lane like crazy this past couple weeks. It's kind of strange, but it's kind of cool too, because I'm reconnecting with people and I'm rediscovering things that I kind of lost interest in along the way. I'm regaining that interest. So one of my favorite bands of all time is Duran Duran. This is Notorious. This was when they were three people after two people went out of the band. It was just Simon, Nick, and Andy. Well, Andy? I think it's Andy. Whoa. And that is from, and this is from that album. It's a very obscure song. It's called, but it's a really very interesting song. I love it. It's called Winter Marches On. Trades on, she drains emotion to drink from her breast of fortune. Dreams have frozen crystal in the morning. Time rose a thorn for coronation. Arise from your rest, we will find enough there to feed you. Soon you'll belong to the blessed. Spare us your lives while we need you. Loud is the music the crowd is bringing out.
Awesome.
Thank you.
I don't know that song at all, man, but that was really cool song.
Different.
Yeah.
It's different.
Nicely done.
It's different from a lot of Duran Duran songs, that's for sure.
Yeah. Awesome, man. Thanks for the little intro there and a little bit of history from the band. That's cool. I love you expressing love for
Duran. Oh, I'm a huge Duran Duran nut,
yeah,
Chad.
Awesome. Yeah, we'll have to talk about it. I need to learn more.
Yes.
Very cool.
Rio.
Yeah, good job.
So, the album Rio. Just saying, the album Rio.
Rich, you're back.
All right.
I'm back.
Awesome.
Okay, Rich, take it away.
Sure. I sit on the ceiling and watch myself sitting at the back of an old classroom. I'm staring out the window at a crow that laughs on a black branch, and I'm that crow staring through the window at the back row and that kid who's now grown older, who's no longer distracted by black flashes of laughter. I stare up at the ceiling, right at me. Right now I'm really confused and all twisted up, wound tight as a drunkard, with nowhere to sleep that's dry from my own damn dreaming. I've strangled my heart so many times. My skin has gone cold and I've become little use to friends and relations. Even less use to those who will tell you that they know you. We all link arm in arm and stare out the window at that black tree, where I sit on a limb singing ain't life grander. It's an odd bird that sits in your hand. It sings an old song that's profane, trouble and sweet, and as we careen towards peace, to fall through a window in a muslin sheet, singing my life grand until that bird takes wing. Your foolish world run off with a lover, so does young and modest and cruel, the kind who will stare deep in your eyes and tell you, baby, 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 everything is gonna be just fine, and you can have everything that you ever wanted. You'll do everything well, you look swell. You're always witty, you're always charming, and everyone in this room is your friend. And as you float on up to the ceiling, to watch the world swirl in a cloud of confetti and some pornographic newsreel that's gone gray, and nothing is real, give me back that black flash of laughter. Give me the sense to fall where I see where I'm standing and endure the cackle of crows till I know that they know that I know that ain't life grand. Man, it's an odd bird that sits in your hand and sings an old song that's profane, troubled and sweet, and as I careen towards peace, to fall through a window in a muslin sheet, singing my life grand until that bird takes wing. My bird takes wing, oh, till my bird takes wing.
God, Rich.
I really love that one.
Wow. Let me ask you one thing. Do you run out of words?
In conversation?
No, I mean in singing and in writing, songwriting.
I'm not exactly sure what you mean. You mean like
Because you have so many.
I'm wordy? I mean, have I used them all up?
Yes. Have you used up all your words yet?
No. But
I'm just kidding.
You know who said that, something like that? Bob Dylan said something like that through Clive Davis to Bruce Springsteen.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
After his like first record, Dylan told Clive Davis to tell him that for Springsteen to be careful because he's about to use up all the words.
Because you have so many.
Springsteen's first record, it's very wordy.
Yeah. Mm.
You know, like Strangers in the Night. I mean, Stranger, what is it? What am I thinking of? The one that Manfred Mann
his did. His first album?
Yeah, the Greetings from Asbury Park.
Blinded by the Light.
Yeah.
But, I wanted to say, like, for me, I repeat my words sometimes in chorus verse chorus. You know, I have the same chorus and things. Mm-hmm. You seem to not have that.
I don't have a lot of songs that have standard choruses.
No.
And if I do have songs that are structurally choruses, they usually have some change in the line. There are some that I have that are that way, but not very many.
And the thing I'm saying is
that one has a sort of pretty much repeated chorus, although I changed the first time it's like talking about us, and then the other one more specifically me. I might play a trick like that, you know.
Yeah, I'm just saying you pack a lot of words into your songs, man. And they're so amazing.
I hope that's a good thing, or I don't know. If it's a good thing or a bad thing.
Oh yeah, totally, totally. You know, it's a good thing.
Story that you're telling.
I wouldn't say that is a bad thing.
No, definitely not.
That's you're very unique, Rich, and we're very happy that you're a regular here.
I love hanging out with you guys and listening and stuff like that. You know, I'm just glad that Vernon turned me on to you guys.
That's great. Hey,
this is really the first Zoom open mic, and I'm really quite an addict to doing them all over the world now. So
yeah,
awesome.
We do one on Sunday nights. You guys should come by.
Yeah, I know. You've been promoting it. That is awesome.
Sunday night. Okay.
Sunday night. I guess it's a little bit late on a Sunday night for East Coast people, but
posted on
East Coast people that do it. We started at 8, which is kind of when the tradition, our open mic started on Sunday nights at the main bar that we used to go to. So.
Okay. Yeah. Have you posted on our page?
Yeah, it's on your thing. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Great.
I can put it in. I'll put it in the chat for what it's worth. But yeah.
Sure. Sure, please do.
Central time, or is it 8 o'clock Eastern time?
8 o'clock Central time. So okay. 9 o'clock Eastern time.
Yep. 9 o'clock Eastern. Okay, great.
3 hours long. That's right.
I'm sorry.
We'll move on. Don't worry. It's all right. We've only got.
Yeah, we'll move on.
Vernon, you're up next, and Marty, if you want to sing us another tune, let me know. Do you? Because you're going to be on deck. Awesome. Sweet. All right, Vernon, take it away.
Fly with John Herb, that tells me in high. John
cut the air with it. Oh, fall, rumble, oh, Jesus, down in the sky. Well, if it tells, standing on his 12th string, John's cut loose with his slide. Jesus kind of hum along, half the sailboats off the side. Light the fuse, aiming a star, right clear up to glory on a blind man's guitar. Blind man's guitar. As you lifted aloft, consider the call. Sorrow's a fuel that would burn you more. Blind man's guitar. Blind man's guitar. Sanctified Durham Dawn, catching the train, New York City, mind your soul, boy, while I'm gone. Birds and crickets singing the thickets, the briars and the nettles and the thorns. But a man comes howling and screaming and raving in this world from the minute he's born. His cries ring the rain from a low-lying cloud, shouts down the rooster in the wind. And guitar. Blind man's guitar. Get riding. Hitching a ride on a muddy dirt road, boss, that ain't gonna get you very far. Try striving, rocking with a turbine engine to the back of a blind man's guitar. His pride drinks the rain from a low-lying cloud, shouts down the rooster in the wind, boy. Blind man's guitar. Man, I could listen all night, but I gotta suggest you blind street singers take your hard-earned rest. Blind man's guitar. Blind man's guitar.
Damn.
Yeah. Oh, you just made me so happy. I really needed that, Vernon.
That's awesome.
Thank you so much, Vernon.
Yo, Vern, that just sounds like such a fun song to play, man. That is so cool.
My goodness.
Hey.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
Nice job, man.
Oh, thanks.
There's some great Tanjay lyric in that song.
The lyric master. Hell yeah, man. I love his music. I mean, honestly, come on, where do you find energy like that?
I want to thank Spoo or Vernon or whatever you want to call yourself. I want to thank you for being a regular too.
Yeah, man. Yeah, he's a dedicated member here, man. He really is
dedicated.
Hell yeah. Marty, you're up next, and then we've got Cindy on deck.
Okay.
What are you going to sing for us, Marty?
Let's see if you can hear it. Can you hear this okay?
You're good.
Thank you.
Getting into it. Wait, come on. We would have that song if you wouldn't have performed that for us tonight. That was awesome.
Oh, yeah, Marty.
That was great.
That was wonderful. Great. I really like that.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Oh, I know. That song is so good. And Marty, you rocked it. You rocked it.
Yeah. I felt
great job.
He sang it. He sung that. He wrote that song for his wife.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I didn't know that. Yeah. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Wow. That's incredible, actually.
You mean Robert Plant did?
Yeah.
Okay.
Very good job.
I thought maybe it was Jimmy Page who wrote it.
I sent it to you, remember?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Marty. That was awesome.
Yeah, that was so cool. Yep, another audience member turned performer. I think that.
Yeah, we're turning people.
I think that's number three.
Yeah.
Yep, at least. It's either three or four. I forget. I have to go back. Cindy,
it must be like three. It must be at least four, I think.
Yeah, because I'm thinking.
Three or four.
Yeah, Cindy was one. So Marty.
Yeah.
And oh my gosh, Liz was one.
And yeah, that's right. She didn't want to perform for a little bit
there. I think there. A lot of people actually now. I think it's actually more than just a few that I'm thinking about it because we've had, I don't know. I'm not going to go over it because my memory sucks anyway. So Cindy, you're up.
My turn.
All right. Yeah, I had to mess with my sound settings a little, Chad. So if you can give me some kind of hand gesture, whether I have to lower or raise the volume, that'd be cool when I start singing.
Yeah, sounds good. Yeah.
Okay.
If you got thumbs up, I'm just going to say yes, go ahead.
That works.
If I go like this, that means turn up.
Okay, great. And yep. The other way, turn down. That sounds good.
This isn't me booing you, though. This is down. I'm turning that music down.
All right. Let's see. This one is some Stevie Nicks. And pardon me if this song is cliche, but it's one of my rockin' ones, and it's a favorite of mine. So
let it rip, Cindy.
Okay. to.
Sings a song, sound flashes.
Oh, hold on. I was paying attention to the volume. Let me start over. Shoot.
Oh yeah, I mean, if you're singing on top of that, I think it's gonna be fine. It sounds.
You think it's gonna be fine? Okay, good.
Yeah. Here we go. Go ahead and just.
Sorry about that.
You're right.
Just like the white winged dove sings a song, sounds like she's singing. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Just like the white winged dove sings a song, sounds like she's singing. Ooh, baby, ooh, say ooh. And the days go by like a strand in the wind, in the web that is my own. I begin again. Said to my friend, baby, nothing else mattered. He was no more than a baby then. Well, he seemed broken-hearted. Something within him. But the moment that I first laid eyes on him, all alone on the edge of 17. Just like the white winged dove sings a song, sounds like she's singing. Ooh, baby, ooh, ooh. Just like the white winged dove sings a song, sounds like she's singing. Said, ooh, baby, ooh, said, ooh. Well, I went today, maybe I will go again tomorrow. Yeah, yeah, well, the music there, well, it was hauntingly familiar. When I see you doing what I try to do for me, with the words from a poet and a voice from a choir and a melody, nothing else mattered. Just like a white winged dove sings a song, sounds like she's singing. Ooh, baby, ooh, say ooh. Just like a white winged dove sings a song, sounds like she's singing. Said ooh, baby, ooh, said ooh. The clouds never expected when it rains, but the sea changes color, but the sea does not change. So with the slow an angel's desire to please on the edge of 17. Ooh, just like the white winged dove sings a song, sounds like she's singing. Ooh, baby, ooh, said ooh. Just like the white winged dove sings a song, sounds like she's singing. Ooh, baby, ooh, said ooh. Well, then suddenly there was no one left standing in the hall. Yeah, yeah, in a flood of tears that no one really ever heard fall at all. When I went searching for an answer up the stairs and down the hall, but not to find an answer, just to hear the call of a nightbird singing, come away, come away, come away. Just like the white winged dove sings a song, sounds like she's singing. Ooh, baby, ooh, say ooh. Just like the white
ranger sings a song, sounds like she's singing. Ooh, baby, ooh, say ooh. When I hear you in the morning, and I hear you at nightfall, sometimes to be near you is to be unable to hear you. My love, I'm a few years older than you. My love, just like the white-winged dove sings a song, sounds like she's singing. Ooh, baby, ooh, said ooh. Just like the white-winged dove sings a song, sounds like she's singing. Ooh, baby, ooh, said ooh. Oh, 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 oh.
Yeah.
Nice.
That's awesome.
Thank you.
That kind of is shit, you know. That's your song.
Awesome. Thank you.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
All right. So we're gonna have Tom Senrud, Jeff.
All right, Tom.
Bob Hausler, sorry, and then Karen. Do you want to sing again?
She's the square one.
I think Karen wants to sing another time. It's getting late for her, she says. So
yeah, okay. Yeah. So just keep that in mind, guys. We're gonna be after 11. But go ahead and take it away, Tom. And then Jeff, you'll be up. Bob and then Karen we'll finish it out.
Well, Karen's not gonna do another one.
Oh, she's not. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay, then just the three of you guys, so you'll be all right. So go ahead, Tom. No rush. I mean, it'll be like 10 or 15 minutes from now.
It'll be just two people.
Oh, so Tom and Jeff?
I live in an apartment building.
Oh, so I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
When I can join you guys earlier, I'll go a second round.
Yeah, that's fine. No problem. Yeah.
I'm sorry. Yeah, it's going to be three people. I'm sorry. Tom, Jeff, and Bob.
And Bob. Okay, good enough. All right, Tom, go ahead without further ado.
Okay.
Tom, that's a riff there. That's a nice riff there.
It is.
Got
for sure.
Good finger practice. There's no way that I could do that.
That's awesome. No way I could do it.
I'm envious. All right, great job, Tom. Good job. Jeff, you're gonna be up next, and then Bob, you are gonna be the new headliner for tonight and close us out.
Yeah, close it out, Bob. All right.
Okay. Well. I was going to do one song up until just now, and for somehow this one just took over. This is a song by Cream and Eric Clapton.
All right.
Thinking about the times you drove in my car. Thinking that I might have drove you too far. And I told you about the kitchen table. I told you not to wander out in the dark. Told you about the swans that they live in the park. And I told you about our kid and I was married to Mabel. There's a town that the light goes up and down. Don't you notice how the wheel goes round? And you better get yourself back off the ground before they bring the curtain down. Now before they bring the curtain down. Thinking about a girl who looks quite like you. She didn't have the time to wait a queue. She cried away her life, said she fell off the cradle.
All right, Jeff. Yeah.
Thanks, everybody.
Some Cream.
Yeah. So Eric Clapton, I'm reading some like crazy history about this song. Like, it was written by Eric Clapton in collaboration with the Beatles guitarist George Harrison.
Yeah, and how it got its name. How it got its name is like, you know, there's like 10 different stories written about it. And you know, it all comes down to it's like it just was scribbled on a piece of paper.
Yeah, that's what they say. The lyrics themselves are not intended to make sense. Many of them were taken from drunken conversations Harrison had with Ringo Starr, supposedly.
Yeah.
From the internet, you know, and it's true or not, but that's awesome. I mean,
on one of Clapton's last tours, they had the girls, you know, the background singers. At the end of the song, as he was doing the guitar outro, the girls start singing, "Where is my badge?"
It's hilarious.
You know, just taking up the humor of the song, you know.
Yeah.
No one knows.
Yep. Add to the chaos a little bit. It makes it more unique and
interesting. Yeah, add to the chaos, exactly.
That's right. Good to hear.
Awesome, awesome song choice, though. That was great. You sound awesome. I love your setup.
Yeah, Marty dug that. Marty dug that.
Oh, bet. Yeah, hell yeah. All right, cool.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Bob.
Yeah, Bob, you're going to close down.
Thank you so much, Jeff.
Yeah, the event here. Hey, Bob, you want to play another tune?
Do you do radio?
Me, personally?
Your voice is perfect for radio.
Are you talking to me?
I'll tell you.
I said Jeff.
Aaron does, yes.
Yeah, Jeff, your voice is radio.
Oh, absolutely. There are some definitely
radio voice.
Voices here. And you have that proper like reverb on that, too. It sounds nice.
Well, what it is I'm using the proximity effect of the microphone so you can get the extra low notes in there.
Yeah.
And you can add the reverb in, you know.
That's so cool.
reverb.
Those effects at your disposal, man. That's so cool. That must be so fun. I really got to set my vocal pattern.
Yeah, Jeff has lots of interesting equipment there.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
No, it's actually, if it's just a, it's a Yamaha mixing console.
Okay.
And I just have the ability to blend in lots of different things. So,
sure.
But it's nice. Just a mixer.
That's cool. Yeah. Cool. Well, it's more than I have.
I know. Bob, go ahead, man.
Bob.
You want something mellow or you want something rocking?
What do you feel? What do you feel, Bob?
I prefer rocking. I think
rocking. Let's do rocking. Oh, yeah.
The shape I'm in, I can't sing, I ain't pretty, and my legs are thin. Don't ask me what I think of you, I might not give the answer that you want me to. Understand, he said, stick by me, he'll be your guiding hand. Don't ask me what I think of you, I might not give the answer that you want me to.
Look at Rachel.
Look at Rachel's got the Zeppelin.
Led Zeppelin.
That's awesome.
Rachel's Led Zeppelin photograph. That's awesome.
Concert.
Nice. That's really nice.
Amazing, Bob. Like, you really do amaze me with that.
Bob, you rocked. Oh, my. That was a mashup. That was an awesome mashup right there. Oh, my God.
That's a good way to end.
That's a great. Sure. That's a great exclamation point to a great night, people.
Yeah, man. Bob, that was so cool.
Bob, that was awesome.
That was awesome, man. Loved it. Loved the energy. Yeah. Thank you all for coming tonight and making all this possible. Without all of our great performers, yeah, it wouldn't be so fun. So catch us next week. Same time, same place. We'll catch you then.
I see Marty.
Oh, yeah.
Marty has a DVD of the amazing
album. I got the original album and everything from way back.
The amazing animated movie narrated by Ringo Starr called The Point, which has
Harry Nilsson. The Point.
Harry Nilsson
remake of it in Yoko.
I've never heard of it. I've never seen it.
Oh, it's so good. It's so good, good you guys. Good night, everybody. We'll see you next week for show tunes. Show tunes, all right?
Yay, Bring your show tunes.
Yeah, it'll be great. All right, take care, everybody. Have a good night.
Have a great week.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye now.